Hey everyone, I'm Shannon if you're new, but today I am starting my workbench and I'm super excited. I'm about to head to Home Depot to pick up all of my stuff. I got my cut list and I'm gonna go pick up Golan and start my workbench. You can see my garage is an absolute disaster. So this will be the first step in making my garage somewhat organized. So let's go pick up Golan. So here are my sketches for my workbench and here is my cut list. In total, I need to get 2 sheets of plywood and 11 2x4s. So first picked out my plywood and I got one of these for my bottom shelf and then one of these as my tabletop. And I got a nicer piece of plywood for the top because I knew I wasn't going to paint it so it would be exposed. Thanks, and because I know it's going to get a lot of use. So next went to go get it cut and I only cut the top of my workbench and the bottom shelf of my workbench at Home Depot just so I could fit it in my car, and then everything else I cut at home. This is the bottom shelf of my workbench and I got this cut to 33 inches wide by 69 inches long. And this is the top of my workbench that I got cut to 36 inches by 73 inches. Also went to get paint samples, which took me a really long time, but finally narrowed it down to 2 colors. Somehow I managed to get everything in my car and then went to go finally start building my workbench.
Hang on.
Yeah.
So just making all of those cuts, finished cutting out all my pieces and then started building the bottom frame. I used 2 2.5 long screws at each joint, and you can use pocket holes if you want, but I'm just impatient and I didn't really mind too much, so I just screwed them right through the wood. And normally I would use wood glue throughout this entire project, but I know that I'm going to move eventually and I know that assembled it won't fit into my car, so I made sure that I would be able to take it apart and bring it with me when that time eventually comes. But if you don't plan on moving, I would advise to use wood glue. It will definitely make your workbench a lot stronger. Now done with the bottom frame and then started attaching the legs, and once again using 2.5 inch long screws. And during this part, make sure you check to make sure that you're avoiding the screws underneath. I put 2 2x4s in each corner and then I added the middle legs that will support the shelf for my table saw, and it should be 16.5 inches away from the end.
Just broke my drill bit. It's a brand new drill bit. I can't tell you how many freaking drill bits I've broken.
But anyways, now building the top frame, and the middle 2x4 should be 18 inches away from the end. And make sure that you're assembling it upside down with the top side on the ground, so using the ground as a flat surface to ensure that the tabletop has a flat surface to sit on. So now I get to attach the top frame to everything else, and once again, make sure you do it upside down so that everything is flat. Using 2.5 inch screws once again, and putting 2 in each 2x4 into the frame. Now attaching the 5-inch long 2x4s. These are the pieces that you attach the wheels to, but I'm not attaching the wheels yet because I'm going to paint my workbench and I don't want to accidentally get paint on them. So this is when I should have put the bottom shelf in, but didn't, and you'll see why I should have put it in now. But instead, I started building my table saw shelf and then attached it, and this is what the shelf looks like when it's all put together. But I started attaching my table saw shelf and I had to use clamps to hold them in place so then I could put the screws in. It was a bit difficult making sure everything was level, but eventually got it and then could start putting in my screws. But first, Lola came to visit.
Come here, mommy. Hi. Oh, hi. Hi, mommy. Hi, mommy.
Back to attaching the support shelf. And I forgot to mention earlier that I'm using a countersink, so all of my screws would sit flush. And then finally finished getting my support shelf up. And you can see it holds a lot of weight. So now I'm attempting to put the bottom shelf in, but as you can see, the table saw shelf is in the way. So instead of taking off the table saw shelf, which was a ton of screws, I just took off one back leg so it could slide in at a flatter angle, and that actually ended up working.
Got the bottom shelf on. It's coming together. So I'm gonna put this back one back on.
So after getting the back leg back on, I started sanding the bottom shelf and I used 80 grit paper and then 120 grit paper.
vacuumed it all up to make sure there was no sawdust, and then I started to fill these holes that were in the plywood. And instead of using wood filler, I always use a mixture of sawdust and wood glue as a wood filler. And I always use the sawdust that I created from sanding, so I know it's the exact same color. So just put the mixture in, and then I'm using a putty knife to just like scrape it flat. And then eventually, once it dries, I'm gonna go back in and sand it. Now I'm using these 1 1/4 inch screws to attach the bottom shelf to the frame. And then after that, I measured the area of the table saw shelf and cut a piece of plywood to 33 inches by 18 1/4 inches, and then used the 1 1/4 inch screws again to attach this as well. And then put my table saw in place to see if it supported it and if it fits. And now I get to move on to sanding. I sanded my entire workbench with 80 grit sandpaper and then 120 grit sandpaper, and then moved on to attaching my tabletop to my workbench. I found some of these laying around my workshop, so I used them to attach my top, and I laid this scrap piece of plywood on top of the workbench to make sure that I was attaching them so they would correctly meet the top. I also found these, but the thing with these ones is that if you just sit them on top, your tabletop will not sit flush on the wood. So I chiseled out little grooves for them to sit in and then attached them, and it ended up looking like this. And here's what they look like when they were all attached. Now I need to cut out the space for my table saw, so I penciled out my dimensions and then used a fat drill bit to cut holes in the corner, and then I used a jigsaw to cut out the piece. And as you can see, I did not make the straightest cut, so I went back in with a chisel and my circular saw to make the edges straight and soft. These two screws on the side of my table saw hold up my push stick, and I'm taking them off so they don't get in the way of the table saw sitting in the cutout, plus I wouldn't be able to grab my push stick anyway from here. And then check to see if my table saw fit in, and it does, and even the fence moves back and forth easily. So I tried out my table saw by starting on my next project, which is my tool wall, and as you can see, a lot of sawdust was produced. And this table saw has no way of adding a dust collection system, so when I used to use it, I would just put a cardboard box underneath it to catch all of the dust. But now I'm going to actually incorporate a dust collection system into my workbench. All I did to do this was just drill a hole underneath my table saw that is the same size as one of my vacuum hoses. And as you can see, the hose fits perfectly, so when I want to use my table saw, I just put the hose through the bottom, turn on my shop vac, and my table saw is good to go. So officially done assembling, and now I can start painting. So I used this primer, and I used a paint roller to get all the big areas first, and then I went back in with a paintbrush to get all the corners and all the areas that a roller couldn't get to, and I did one coat of primer and then let it dry for 2 hours. This is the paint I'm using, Winter Way from Home Depot, and like I did with the primer, I'm using a roller for all the bigger areas and then going back in with a paintbrush for all the corners, and I did a total of 3 coats of paint. So now moving on to the top, I forgot to record it, but I sanded the top with 80 grit, 120 grit, and 220 grit paper. Then I took a tack cloth to wipe it down and made sure there was no sawdust on it, and then started to apply polyurethane with this synthetic bristled brush. And I did a total of 5 coats of polyurethane because I really wanted to make sure that it was super durable. And this is what it looked like with all 5 layers of poly on it. So I originally wasn't planning on putting polyurethane on the bottom shelf and the table saw shelf, but realized that it is really noticeable and don't want it to get scratched up. So ended up putting 1 layer of polyurethane on the bottom shelf and the table saw shelf. Now I'm going to attach the casters to the bottom, and with these small washers and screws, I'm just attaching them all. And these wheels cost about $10 a piece. So using those 2 screws I took off my table saw earlier, I'm going to attach them to my workbench to hold my push stick. So first I played around with what felt the most natural, and I just am attaching it now.
Sorry.
You're chilling. I'm actually attaching my push stick to my bench.
Oh, of course. What else would you need?
This is a push stick.
Oh, okay.
It's like when you use it to push wood through so you don't get your fingers close to it.
Nice. Should be right there.
Yeah, so it's like easily.
That's nice.
Grabbable.
You don't love food?
He's coming. Can you hear her?
Oh my.
She's coming. She'll be like, what's that? Listen. You found this! You found this!
Is that you?
Ooh, push stick is in place. Look how good it looks.
It's beautiful.
And it's super sturdy.
So I'm finally done with my workbench. And remember, this is what the side of my garage looked like before. And there's my table saw. And here's what it looks like now. Absolutely love it. And I actually intentionally left a bunch of open space on this workbench because I want to add stuff to it over time and see how I use it. So I'll probably eventually post a part two of my workbench showing my updates and additions I made.
My workbench is done. I am super excited. I love how it looks, especially with my tool wall behind it, which also that video is coming next. But it looks great. It makes my garage look so much nicer. It makes me want to work. I get excited to work. Also, it makes cutting bigger items so much easier for, and now I have so much extra space so I can easily cut plywood. So I love it. I'm so excited, and it's super, like, I can support my weight really easily. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.